अस्सलामु अलैकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू आर विल बी ऑल ओके। आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज बायो टेक्नोलॉजी, चैप्टर 17, सब्जेक्ट बायोलॉजी, क्लास 10। बायो टेक्नोलॉजी इज ड्राइव्ड फ्रॉम टू वर्ड्स। बायो means life, technology means a set of techniques related to and related for life. Different techniques used for benefit of man, for services of man, and for producing the substances from living organisms, from other living organisms, just for the benefit or usefulness or welfare of man. The use of other animals for man is called biotechnology. There are two forms of biotechnology. There are two types of biotechnology: old biotechnology and modern biotechnology. Old biotechnology is known for many and many years back in the history of mankind. People were well aware with the techniques of the biotechnology, in particular producing various varieties of plants by vegetative propagation, by using the asexual capabilities of plants, by producing new varieties of the plants from old ones, was a prevalent method in the historic days of man. In the animals category, the animal breeding, producing best animals out of the others, was a technique used in biotechnology. The crop varieties and the animal breeds were a result of the biotechnology in the old days. Also, people were aware how to make use of the milk. They were making yogurt, cheese, etc., the milk products, by using the microbial abilities. They, although were not fully aware with the microscopic aspect, but they knew how to make the other products out of milk. These techniques were fermentation. They were developed with the time. Various fermenting abilities of the microscopic organisms were used in old biotechnology. So, old biotechnology is defined the use of fermentation and related simple processes for making the products useful for humankind. But modern biotechnology, which arose recently in the mid to late 20th century, old biotechnology uses the old methods, but modern biotechnology, which arose around mid or 20th century, is a new biotechnology. It uses new methods for getting most of the animals for mankind. Modern biotechnology is also called genetic engineering. Genetic engineering or modern biotechnology, both are synonymous with each other. इन जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग और इन मॉडर्न बायोटेक्नोलॉजी जीन्स आर स्टडीड द फंक्शंस ऑफ जीन्स आर स्टडीड एंड द रोल ऑफ द जीन्स इन कंट्रोलिंग द नॉर्मल बॉडी प्रोसेसेस इज आल्सो स्टडीड इट इज कंट्रोल्ड द ओल्ड जीन्स आर रिमूव्ड फ्रॉम द बॉडी एंड द न्यू जीन्स आर एंटर्ड इनटू द बॉडी The work on genetic engineering started in 1944 when it was first that man got the information that DNA contains genetic information. In 1944 it was clear that DNA contains genetic information and it was the start of the work on modern biotechnology or genetic engineering. With the development in the time in 1970s, in the 10 years following 19th century, man was able to cut and paste DNA, cut dangerous defective DNA piece and paste in its place a normal piece of DNA. It was accomplished in 1970s. In 1978, in the last year of 1980s, 10 years, in 1978, man produced insulin by inserting insulin gene into the bacteria. Man was successful in producing insulin hormone, a hormone controlling the glucose metabolism in the body, by inserting the gene of insulin into the bacteria or microorganism. And in 1990, the work of Human Genome Project started. The work on Human Genome Project started in 1990. Human Genome Project was a scheme whose mission was to map all the genes present in the humans. By knowing which gene is present in human being, man is able to do with that gene. Every gene in every animal produces a particular product, and by knowing the details of every gene, it is possible to recover many genetic disorders, and it was started in 1990. In 2002, the work on Human Genome Project was completed and published. It was available to the worldwide media. And it is a big success of scientists. The modern biotechnology has revolutionized the world. Many other techniques like tissue culture, cloning, etc. are also an aspect, a grouping of modern biotechnology. But old biotechnology only includes the old method of fermentation. Next will be discussed soon. Assalamu alaikum dear students, how are you all? I hope you all will be all okay. Our topic is the scope of biotechnology, class 10, chapter 17, biology. The scope or importance of biotechnology is not as small as you might think. Biotechnology is very much fast growing subject discipline nowadays in the modern science. Biotechnology has revolutionized the world, in particular in the fields of medicine, agriculture, environment, organic chemistry, and microbiology. We will discuss the importance of biotechnology described in your book in short. In the fields of medicine, biotechnology has revolutionized the scientists. Many antibiotics are obtained by bacteria by using the biotechnological techniques like genetic engineering. These antibiotics are used for bacterial infections. Other types of medicines which are produced by using biotechnological techniques are vaccines. These medicines are used for bacterial and viral infections before the attack of disease. The production of vaccines has eliminated from its base many diseases in the world, and that is a miracle. By using the biological techniques like biotechnology, man has been able to make growth hormone along with various others hormone. This hormone has resolved the problems of being dwarfed for most of the people whose life has become just a junk. Being too much small or dwarf is nowadays a dilemma, but this can be solved by the help of the product of the genetic engineering or modern biotechnology, that is by taking the growth hormone. The growth hormone is a miraculous product, a miraculous hormone produced by genetic engineering or modern biotechnology. Other hormone which has resolved the diabetes is insulin. It is used for the patients of diabetes mellitus who have excess of glucose in their blood, who cannot control the blood, because the function of this hormone is to control the level of the glucose in the blood. If it is not produced normally by the body, its supply from outside is increased. But how to supply it from outside without the biotechnology? Obviously, biotechnology has also produced the insulin hormone successfully. Another miraculous way to treat the diseases by genes is gene therapy. Gene therapy means the use of the gene for diseases. Each and every product of our cell is under control of a particular gene. And if that product is not being farmed out, if a part of cell or a body is not functioning properly, then the respective defective gene is removed, and in place of that defective gene, a new gene is inserted. Such a technique is called gene therapy, and it is a sub-technique of genetic engineering, meaning the modern biotechnology. In the forensics, for the identification of the criminals, the biotechnology is used. The knowledge of DNA also makes the scientists able to recognize the criminals by matching their DNAs. The interviral antiviral proteins called interferons are also being developed only and only with the help of biotechnology. Previously, it was considered that viral infection cannot be eliminated. But nowadays, because of the biotechnology, two medicines, one before the attack of disease called interferon, and the other after the one before the attack of the disease of the virus called vaccines are used, and the other type of the medicines which are used after the attack of the viral infections called interferons are produced only and only because of the biotechnology. Biotechnology has also revolutionized the agricultural fields. In the field of agriculture, biotechnology has done no less than in the fields of medicine. in the field of agriculture, biotechnology has made it able for scientists to make many fermented foods which add taste and variety to the foods. The fermented foods like yogurt, cheese, and various forms of pickles are tasty as well as optional and serve as a fast food and favorite food for most of the people. And these fermented foods are owing to the use of biotechnology. The malted foods are another benefit of biotechnology, and the malted foods include the powdered milk. The powdered milk consists of three things: barley, wheat flour, and whole milk. When mixed together, results in a malt that used as malted foods. It is nutritious, tasty, as well as serving as fast food. Various beverages, in particular alcoholic beverages, are because of biotechnology. These include wine, many types of wines, beers, champagne, etc. Every home or everyone wants to use such beverages, though Muslims are not allowed. Plants are made transgenic by the help of the techniques of the biotechnology, in particular the modern biotechnology, that is genetic engineering. Transgenic plants are the plants whose genetic makeup has been changed. Trans means change, genic means genes, whose genes have been changed. Those plants which have more favorable characteristics, which have best characteristics, are chosen, and their best genes are transferred into the other plants using genetic engineering. Such plants whose genetic makeup or genes have been changed are called transgenic plants. Biotechnology has produced transgenic plants for getting from them better yield, better crop production on yearly base, and also for getting the plants which are resistant to diseases, to the insects and herbicides. Such an attainment is a miracle in the science industry and in the world of the science, and it is only because of biotechnology. Biotechnology has made the man able to make transgenic plants which have the ability to produce more crops in less time, to raise resistance, to be avoided, to protect themselves from the harshness of the weather, from the severeness of the weather. Also, these transgenic plants are able to fight with the diseases, with the insecticides, pesticides, or other harmful chemicals to the plants. Transgenic animals like transgenic plants have their genetic makeup changed by using genetic engineering, and these transgenic animals are able to give more milk, more meat, and also various medicines are obtained from the animals, from their urine, from their blood, or from their hormones. Many vitamins are obtained from the plants which are useful for humankind. So, in the field of agriculture, biotechnology is a fast growing modern science. in the field of environment or for environment, biotechnology is extremely important. And its importance in environment, the importance of biotechnology in environment surpasses the others. Because if environment is under control, then everything is under control. And biotechnology has also revolutionized the control mechanisms of environment. For example, pollution is controlled by various biotechnological techniques. Microorganisms are used for pollution control. The harmful substances present in the environment are eliminated, and by the elimination of these harmful substances from the environment, pollution is controlled. Various renewable resources are built, produced by biotechnology by using the fast-growing capabilities of microorganisms. Biopesticides are the chemicals which are used for killing the pests. Pesticides means any chemicals which are used for killing pests. Pests are harmful animals for plants. The animals which destroy plants are called pests. And the chemicals available in the markets which kill these harmful insects or plants may also be called pests if they destroy other plants. The many pesticides available in the markets, but chemicals. The living organisms, when used as pesticides, are called biopesticides. For example, an insect is harming a plant, and that insect can be eaten another insect larger in size but not dangerous to that plant. If we add that larger insect to crops, then there will be no damage to the crop, but the insects serving as a pest destroying the plant will be killed. Thereby, the chances of less or no pests in the field will cause the plant to grow vigorously and an increase in the crop yield. Biofertilizers are the products or animals which are used as fertilizers. For example, earthworm increases the fertility of soil. The dung and the waste material of many animals serve as fertilizers, and these are collectively called the products as well as animals, biofertilizers. These increase the fertility of the soil. So you don't need chemical fertilizers and to cost much for it. And it is because of, again, I will like to say, biotechnology. Biosensors are the animals or the parts of animals which sense the changes in the environment, like a hurricane or a storm or a havoc. They inform you beforehand at what you want to or what you should to do in the future to save yourself from the havocs of the environment. The sewage treatment is also possible because of biotechnology. Sewage water is waste, dirty, bad, foul water. It is purified by using microorganisms. So there are two benefits in one. Pollution is controlled as well as there is water available to you. Many other microorganisms used in environment include those who are used for the purification of the spilled oil and conservation or recovery of various metals. Such is an importance of biotechnology in the field of medicine, in the field of food and agriculture, and in the field of the environment. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, all students. How are you all? Our topic is fermentation. Class 10, Biology, Chapter 17, Biotechnology topic, fermentation. Today we will discuss about fermentation. What is fermentation? Fermentation is a biochemical process which is similar to cellular respiration. We know what is cellular respiration. The breaking of CH bonds present in the food by use of oxygen, by oxidation and reduction reaction, or complete oxidation and reduction of food resulting in production of energy in the form of ATP is called cellular respiration or aerobic respiration. Fermentation is like aerobic respiration, but just in the start. The first step of aerobic respiration called glycolysis, and the first step of fermentation is also called glycolysis. After the glycolysis is over, fermentation takes another route away from aerobic respiration. Fermentation is also called anaerobic respiration. It involves the breakdown of glucose into pyruvic acid or pyruvate. One molecule of glucose is broken into two molecules of pyruvate, also called pyruvic acid. This step, first step of fermentation, is called glycolysis, and it is same in fermentation as well as aerobic respiration. Scientists many years ago, before the modern discoveries in this field of science, thought that fermentation is just a chemical process. But in 1857, Louis Pasteur convinced all the scientific community that fermentation is not a chemical process, but it is purely a biochemical process. To all the types of fermentation, or particular type of microorganism is always involved. And a type of fermentation is specialized or characterized by a particular type of the microorganism. For example, when glucose is broken down into the pyruvic acid, this initial step is crucial. After the formation of pyruvic acid, there are two pathways. Either lactic acid is produced by the breakdown of pyruvic acid, or alcohols are produced by the breakdown of the pyruvic acid. When pyruvic acid results in lactic acid, the type of fermentation is called lactic acid fermentation. And when pyruvic acid is broken down into alcohol and carbon dioxide, then it is called alcoholic fermentations. Means the type of the end product names the type of fermentation. Alcoholic fermentation is the fermentation in which end product of the fermentation is alcohol and carbon dioxide. Lactic acid fermentation is the fermentation in which the end product is lactic acid only, no carbon dioxide. Now, as I already have described it, that alcoholic fermentation and lactic acid fermentation being the two types of the fermentation will also be controlled by two types of the organisms. Alcoholic fermentation is controlled by the fungus yeast. Many types of yeasts control alcoholic fermentation. In alcoholic fermentation, alcohol and carbon dioxide are produced from the breakdown of a pyruvic acid. Alcoholic fermentation is used to obtain bread, wine, and beer. The most fermented food, which is favorite of most of the people, is bread. Wine and beer are also very common in the Western countries or cultures. These are a product of alcoholic fermentation. We get bread, wine, beer, and other spirited drinks by the help of alcoholic fermentation. You see, bread is swollen soft. The reason for rising or swelling or softening of the bread is the trapped carbon dioxide. When during the alcoholic fermentation carbon dioxide is released, it gets entrapped in the particles, in the spaces present between the particles of the bread. That is why bread seems to be swollen. These act as fast food. Alcoholic fermentation is aided or controlled by various yeasts of genus Saccharomyces, in particular Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Now we talk about the other type of the fermentation depending upon the end product, that is lactic acid fermentation, which is when lactic acid is formed from the breakdown of pyruvic acids. Lactic acid fermentation is carried out by bacteria called lactic acid bacteria. Lactobacillus and Streptobacillus are the bacteria which are used for lactic acid fermentation. By using the lactic acid fermentation, we get butter, yogurt, cheese, and we also make pickles. Means we can store the food with the help of lactic acid and some salt. So each type of fermentation is defined by the end product of the fermentation, and each type of the fermentation is under control of a particular type of microorganism, as alcohol by yeast, Saccharomyces cerevisiae, lactic acid by bacteria, Lactobacillus and Streptobacillus or Streptococcus, these bacteria. Our next topic is applications of fermentation. What are uses of fermentation or applications of fermentation? First of all, we will discuss applications of fermentation for producing fermented foods. Which foods are obtained by fermentation? Many foods are obtained by fermentation nowadays, which include cereal products, dairy products, and fruits and vegetables. Cereal products means those products of fermentation which are used as cereal, which we use in daily life, like bread, cakes, various grains, etc. The most commonly produced fermented product or the commonest cereal product produced by fermentation is bread. Bread is fermented by using alcoholic fermentation of
डो। व्हेन डो इज मिक्स्ड विद द यीस्ट पाउडर, यीस्ट कन्वर्ट्स द डो इनटू ब्रेड, व्हिच इज बोथ टेस्टी एंड न्यूट्रिशियस। नाउ वी टॉक अबाउट द डेयरी प्रोडक्ट्स, द डेयरी फूड्स ऑब्टेंड बाय फर्मेंटेशन। डेयरी प्रोडक्ट्स आर ऑब्टेंड बाय फर्मेंटेशन ऑफ द मिल्क एंड दीज इंक्लूड चीज, योगर्ट, बटर एटसेट्रा। चीज इज ऑब्टेंड बाय फर्मेंटेशन ओवर प्रोटीन प्रेजेंट इन मिल्क। व्हेन अ प्रोटीन प्रेजेंट इन मिल्क इज कोगुलेटेड बिकम्स सॉलिड, इट इज कॉल्ड चीज। मिल्क कंसिस्ट ऑफ वाटर, प्रोटीन्स एंड अदर डिजॉल्व्ड पार्टिकल्स। व्हेन द प्रोटीन्स प्रेजेंट इन द मिल्क आर कोगुलेटेड, व्हेन प्रोटीन इन मिल्क इज कोएग्यूलेटेड, चीज इज फॉर्म्ड। यू नो चीज इज लाइक सॉफ्ट सॉलिड बॉल एंड कोएग्यूलेटेड मीन्स ट्रांसफर ऑफ मिल्क इनटू सॉफ्ट सॉलिड सब्सटेंस। यूजली प्रोटीन डजेंट शो एज सॉफ्ट सॉलिड मटेरियल इन दी मिल्क बिकॉज इट is suspended permanently, but when by different techniques or biotechnology using some bacteria, like using some lactic acid bacteria, the milk protein is coagulated, means separated and turned into soft solid ball, which is cheese. And cheese again is very much nutritious as well as tasty. Now we come to the yogurt, another dairy product. Yogurt is obtained by the action of lactic acid bacteria, lactic acid bacteria sour the milk, and when milk gets sour it is called yogurt. Again yogurt is tasty and nutritious. Various fruits and vegetables can be preserved for long time without a need for refrigerators or fridges. You can store fruits and vegetables by using the technique of fermentation, and this is done by using salt, lactic acid bacteria and some other ingredients to add the taste to this preserved mass of fruits or vegetables. The preserved fruits or vegetables through fermentation are called pickles. So fermentation helps in making the pickles, which doesn't require the fruits or vegetables to be put into refrigerators for their preservation or saving. Next, our topic is beverages. In applications of fermentation biotechnology, chapter 17, biology, class 10. Beverages means drinks. In particular, many alcoholic drinks or beverages are obtained through the process of fermentation. The beverages here means alcoholic beverages, means alcoholic drinks, and these include beer, wine, champagne, etc. Out of all the alcoholic beverages discussed in your book are beer and wine. Beer is an alcoholic drink made by fermenting abilities of yeast. To make beer, yeast is used. Yeast ferments the powder of barley and by this beer is produced, which is tasty and also produces other ecstatic effects. Yeast ferments barley into beer, but this is not done directly. First, the grains of the barley are malted, then dried and turned into fine powder. Yeast acts on this fine powder. Fine means very small pieces of the powder. Many small pieces are called fine, and powder means something which consists of very small soft pieces. So the powder of barley, when it consists of very fine pieces of barley, then it is possible for yeast to make beer out of it by the fermentation ability of yeast. Wine is another alcoholic drink. It is produced simply as compared to beer. No malting, drying or grinding the grains is required for production of wine. Wine is produced directly from grapes. Grapes are fermented directly using yeast. The fermenting abilities of yeast are also used to produce wine from grapes. These alcoholic drinks are produced by fermentation process using yeast. Our next topic is industrial products. In applications of fermentation biotechnology, chapter 17, biology, class 10. Which industrial products are obtained by fermentation? This we will discuss today. Many industrial products are obtained by using fermenting abilities of organisms, out of which four are discussed in your book. Formic acid, is an industrial product obtained by the use of fermentation. Ethanol is another industrial product of fermentation. glycerol is also an addition, and acrylic acid is another industrial product of fermentation. Now we will know that which microorganisms are used to produce these products out of fermentation. To produce formic acid, a special type of yeast is used. This type of yeast is called Aspergillus. Aspergillus is a yeast, it is a fungus, not type of yeast, but a type of fungus. Although yeast is also a type of fungus. We use Aspergillus to produce formic acid by fermentation. Ethanol is obtained by using a type of yeast called Saccharomyces. Glycerol is also obtained by using a type of yeast called Saccharomyces. Acrylic acid is the only product mentioned in here which is obtained by using a microorganism other than fungi, and this is bacteria bacillus. The bacteria which fall under genus Bacillus carry out fermentation to produce acrylic acid. So you have always to associate the product with the microorganism. Formic acid is obtained by using a fungus Aspergillus. Ethanol is obtained by using a fungus Saccharomyces. Glycerol is obtained by using a fungus Saccharomyces. But acrylic acid is obtained by using bacteria related to genus Bacillus. Now we'll talk about the applications of these products obtained by these microorganisms. Formic acid is used in textile dyeing, means to color the textiles, to color the threads out of which dresses are sewn. Formic acid is also used in electroplating. Electroplating means using one metal on another metal to store, to save that underlying metal. For the process of electroplating, formic acid is used. Another use of formic acid is in leather treatment. Still another in rubber production. Formic acid obtained by Aspergillus is used in a variety of ways, in textile dyeing, in electroplating, in leather treatment, or in the production of rubber. Now we will learn the uses of ethanol. Ethanol is used in alcoholic beverages, and also ethanol is used as a solvent, means to dissolve the materials which are having the same polarity like ethanol. The uses of glycerol include: it is used as a solvent. Glycerol is used as a solvent. It is used in the manufacture of cosmetics, plastics, and soap. Glycerol, a fermented product of Saccharomyces, is used as a solvent in cosmetics, in plastics, and in the production of soap. Glycerol is also used as a sweetener. It is used as a sweetener in various bakery products, in biscuits, buns, cakes, cookies. Glycerol is used to add sweetness. Now we will talk about the use of acrylic acid. Acrylic acid obtained by using bacilli is used in production of plastics. Plastics are made out of acrylic acid. These are also using glycerol in their manufacture. Our next topic is fermenters. Biotechnology, Chapter 17, Biology, Class 10. What are fermenters? What are they used for? And what is the importance of fermenters? This we will discuss in this video. Fermenters are vessels or devices used to carry out controlled fermentation. Special types of devices and vessels, or you may say containers, are used for controlled fermentation. It helps to produce a large number of the products within short time and without much expenses. Depending upon the design of fermenters, there are two types of fermentation: batch fermentation and continuous fermentation. Depending upon the design, shape, or lookup of fermenter, there are two types of fermentation: batch fermentation and continuous fermentation. Both of these type of fermentation use some things in common, and these substances are fresh culture, which may also be called pure culture. second thing which is used in fermenters for batch fermentation or continuous fermentation is raw material. And the third thing is food supplements. Raw material means substrate. The materials which have to be fermented are called raw materials. The materials which are used to produce the products are called raw materials. The fermentation of raw materials is done. Now, what is fresh culture or pure culture? Fresh culture or pure culture are the bacteria which have not been used before. The bacteria or other microbes which are to be used in fermentation for fermenting the raw materials are called fresh culture or pure culture. You can use the term fresh culture bacteria or pure culture bacteria, or you may simply use the term fresh culture or pure culture. What are food supplements? Food supplements are the additives, the extra food which is added to the fermenters for vigorous growth of microorganisms or fresh culture. These three things are added either in batch fermentation or in continuous fermentation. Also, before the process of fermentation to continue, the pH the temperature etc. are set to optimum. The temperature and the pH of the fermenters is set at an optimum for optimum growth of fresh culture and for making the process of fermentation faster. Now we differentiate between batch fermentation and continuous fermentation, which depends upon the design of the fermenters. In batch fermentation, the design of the fermenter is like this. In batch fermentation, three holes or three openings in the fermenter are present. From this opening, fresh culture is added to the fermenter, and from this hole, raw material is added to the fermenter. Here a stirrer or a mixture is present, which mixes the fresh culture with the raw material for fermentation to be carried out. Now from this bottom hole comes out the fermented products along with the used culture, mean the microorganisms which have used by the process. After getting the products from the batch fermentation, all the fermenter is cleaned, sterilized, and then again we add raw material and fresh culture and start the process again. After once we have done the process, because after one time doing of the process in batch fermentation, we have to clean and sterilize the fermenter to start the process again. That is why this type of fermentation is called batch fermentation. We are getting the product all at one, but in intervals. Now we will discuss the continuous fermenters or continuous fermentation depending upon the other design of fermenter. In continuous fermentation, the design of the fermenters is like this. It consists of two holes. From this hole, continuously raw material is added. The material which has to be fermented, the substrate means, is added from this hole into the fermenter. A fresh culture is always in the fermenter. Fresh culture is not continuously added or not added once like in batch fermentation. Continuous fermentation has fresh culture put inside it without using another opening. The same opening, the same hole from which raw material is added into the fermenter. In continuous fermentation, same hole is used for adding the fresh culture into the fermenter. When raw material combines with the fresh culture converts the raw material into the products which are obtained from the bottom hole. As long as or as continuously the raw material is added into fresh culture keeps on growing, because raw material is a food for fresh culture. So adding the raw material continuously incessantly without a stop adds to the growth of fresh culture, which will in turn increase the process of fermentation. So what is the main difference between batch fermentation and continuous fermentation is that in batch fermentation we get the products at intervals with the stop in two separate processes, but in continuous fermentation we get the product continuously without any interval. This is just a difference in operating of the process. The products obtained at the end of the batch fermentation and at the end of continuous fermentation after a given time is same. For example, you have carried out batch fermentation, you are counting just the active hours of the process of batch fermentation, and those hours are say 2 hours. You have used the batch fermentation for 2 hours, and this includes the active 2 hours, not the time to clean the fermenters is counted. Within these 2 active hours, a batch fermentation process has produced 50 tons of products. Now about continuous fermentation, within same 2 hour time duration you will also get 50 tons of the products. mean the working ability of batch fermentation and continuous fermentation is the same. Within same time you get the same amount of the product. I hope the importance of fermentation is already clear to you, but as is a topic in your book separate for the significance or importance of fermenters, I will also elicit it up to you, explain it up to you, the importance of fermenters. First of all, fermenters monitor and control the process of fermentation, which is a major step in the fermentation industry. That these devices not only control but monitor each and every change in the process. Fermenters optimize pH, food, substrate, culture, temperature, and everything which is necessary for fermentation to be carried out at an ease and at a fast rate is provided by fermenters. Now, if all of this is done by fermenters, what is the benefit of the fermenters? Is fermenters gives massive amount of products, large amounts of products like various hormones, growth hormone, insulin, various medicines are nowadays being obtained by using fermenters. This is one benefit of using fermenters. Another benefit of using fermenters is that all the massive large amount of the products is obtained by using fermenters in very much less time. Too less time is required to obtain too much products. The third benefit of using the fermenters is that less land or less people are required for operating on fermenters, which makes the use of fermenters inexpensive. We don't have to spend too much money on the use of fermenters, and also we are getting more products. The fifth benefit or the importance of the fermenters is the products which are obtained by using fermenters are pure, neat and clean. Next, we will discuss objectives of genetic engineering, chapter 17, biotechnology, class 10, biology. Objectives of genetic engineering means purposes of genetic engineering. What are purposes of genetic engineering? Genetic engineering is used for the following purposes, for the following objectives. First of which is isolation of जेन फॉर पर्पसेस लाइक जीन थेरेपी.
फॉर एग्जाम्पल, यू आर डिफिशेंट इन अ जीन और यू आर हैविंग अ डिस्टर्ब्ड जीन. द रिमूवल ऑफ जीन एंड रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ डिस्टर्ब्ड जीन, मैल फंक्शनिंग जीन विद अ गुड फंक्शनिंग विद ऑल ओके जीन.
Isolation means separation, and gene therapy means treatment of diseases by using genes which have been isolated. The second objective or purpose of genetic engineering is to produce specific RNA and protein molecules.
All organisms are made up of proteins, and RNA help in the production of proteins. The production of RNA and proteins artificially by using genetic engineering is another objective of genetic engineering.
It is a subtopic of
nowadays prevalent nanotechnology called DNA or RNA nanotechnology.
The third
objective of genetic engineering is
treatment of genetic disorders
in higher organisms, in higher animals, and in higher plants. Genetic disorders are the disorders which fall down the generations, which are transferred from parents to the offspring or children. Such disorders can only and only be treated, cured by using genetic engineering.
The fourth advantage or
objective or purpose of genetic engineering is
to produce plants or animals also of desired characteristics. For example,
a cow gives more milk and you want to have your cow transferred into that type of cow. The best gene of that cow will be planted into your cow, and this now your transgenic cow will start to give as more milk as that one is giving. Or a plant which is resistant to disease, the gene which is able in that plant for resistance is taken and introduced into a plant which is not having that gene. By the planting of that disease resistant gene into the plant which was not having it, that plant is also turned into resisting against the disease. So, to produce plants or animals of desired characteristics is another genetic engineering's objective, or an objective of genetic engineering.
The fifth objective of genetic engineering,
to produce enzymes,
drugs, produce better enzymes drugs etc. Various drugs enzymes and proteins are produced in a better way by using genetic engineering.
Next we will discuss the steps of genetic engineering. Chapter 17 biotechnology, class 10 biology. Which steps are involved in genetic engineering?
The first step is isolation of gene of interest. Gene of interest means which genes you want to make the copies of, means the desired gene. Isolation means separation.
Isolation of gene of interest is the first step of genetic engineering. The separation of desired gene or isolation of gene of interest is done by using DNA and special types of cutters, molecular scissors, special types of enzymes called restriction endonucleases are used for cutting a piece of DNA, means gene from DNA. A piece of DNA is called gene, and to cut this gene of interest from the whole chromosome, the special types of enzymes used are called restriction endonucleases. These are called restriction endonucleases because they are restricted to, bound to cut just that gene which we need. Restriction endonucleases just separate or cut the desired gene. They do not do any cutting or harm to the other nearby genes. That is why their name is. Restriction endonucleases may also be termed as molecular scissors because they act like scissors, mean like a cutter. A piece of DNA or desired gene is separated, isolated in the first step by using restriction endonucleases. In the second step, gene of interest is attached to or linked to a vector. The second step is the use of vector. What is vector? Vector in biology is any organism or a part of organism which takes one thing from one organism and gives it to another organism. A vector acts like a medium to take one thing from one organism and deliver that thing into another organism. And in genetic engineering, vector means an organism or a piece of organism, in particular plasmids or bacteriophages act as vectors.
Plasmids are extra chromosomal DNA of bacteria. For example, this is a bacterium. A bacterium consists of two types of DNA. One DNA is called chromosomal DNA, and the other type of the DNA present in bacteria are extra chromosomal DNA. This is chromosomal DNA, and these two are non-chromosomal DNA. These non-chromosomal DNA may also be called plasmids. The role of the chromosomal DNA is in bacteria reproduction, but the role of the plasmids in bacteria is controlling metabolism. These extra chromosomal DNA or bacteria are called plasmids, and plasmids are generally used for as a vector for taking the gene of interest from one organism and delivering it into another organism. Plasmids serve as a vector. The gene of interest is attached to a vector DNA, means a plasmid in most cases, by using some special types of enzymes which are called ligases. Ligases are joining enzymes, whereas restriction endonucleases are breaking enzymes. The piece of DNA which we have separated in the first step is linked into the vector DNA by using joining enzymes called ligases. At this step also, endonucleases are used. In the second step, first we separate the vector DNA. Imagine this is vector DNA. We cut a piece of vector DNA. This very small piece of vector DNA is cut by the help of restriction endonucleases. Now this was our gene of interest which we have isolated in the first step. First we use this restriction endonuclease to cut a piece of DNA of vector. Then we paste the isolated gene into here by using joining enzymes called ligases. Now you see and you know the DNA piece from here to here is that of vector. It is vector DNA, and this very small piece is isolated gene of interest. Because now vector DNA has a mix of two DNAs, now vector DNA contain a foreign gene. That is why this vector DNA is now a mix, and it is now called recombinant DNA. Recombinant DNA is defined as a DNA which is a mix of two DNAs. When one organism's DNA is mixed with another organism's DNA, the new DNA is called recombinant DNA. This second step of genetic engineering is very much crucial and essential. Genetic engineering is also named recombinant DNA technology, depending upon the production of recombinant DNA, which is an essential step in genetic engineering. Genetic engineering is also called recombinant DNA technology because of this second step. Now we will talk about the third step involved in genetic engineering. The third step involved in genetic engineering is insertion of recombinant DNA into host. When host, for example bacteria, have a recombinant DNA inserted or entered into them, they become genetically modified organism. This third step can also be called the production of GMO. GMO means genetically modified organism. An organism whose genetic makeup is changed because it is having an extra DNA which is not a part of its DNA, the recombinant DNA. For example, this was a host or bacterium before insertion or adding of recombinant DNA to it. So this is not a GMO bacterium. When we have added the recombinant DNA to it, which was like this, having a foreign gene, then this bacterium is now called GMO because it has a recombinant DNA inserted into it. This is not a GMO because it is not having recombinant DNA in it. But this bacterium or host is recombinant DNA, and because of the presence of recombinant DNA, it is called genetically modified organism or GMO. Now comes the fourth step in genetic engineering. This fourth step of genetic engineering is called growth of GMO. Growth of genetically modified organism is made possible in this step by providing the genetically modified organisms proper growth medium and proper environment for much and more growth of genetically modified organism. During growth of GMO, this fourth step, a large number of genetically modified organism form. From this one GMO, there will be form two genetically modified organism, and from two there will be formed four, from 4 to 8, and so on. In a very less time, because an optimum environment is provided, a very much large number of bacteria or genetically modified organism are produced. in the fifth step, which is called expression of gene of interest or the expression of gene in GMO. This is the last step of genetic engineering. In this step, the gene which is present in GMO and which has been taken from outside the gene of interest in the first step, the gene we took, expresses itself, and the plasmids or vectors or the host or the bacteria or GMO which we have used for this purpose doesn't know that it is actually replicating a foreign DNA. It takes the foreign DNA as it is, the DNA of the host. That is why when new GMO forms, there is a new copy of that desired gene of interest. Much more number of gene of interest have been produced in the growth phase in the fourth step. Now in this last step, all of these genes express themselves. They produce the desired proteins which were deficient and which were required to produce, for which we carried out the genetic engineering. Expression of genes means production of the proteins or products which were required. Our next topic is achievements of genetic engineering. Chapter 17, Biotechnology, Class 10, Biology. Achievements of genetic engineering mean which major products we have obtained or we are obtaining by genetic engineering. By genetic engineering, man has made insulin. The production of insulin outside of body has been possible only because of genetic engineering. This hormone controls glucose in blood, and the patients of diabetes need this hormone from outside. Nowadays, patients of diabetes or diabetics are getting insulin which has been prepared or which is being produced by genetic engineering. This is one achievement of genetic engineering. The second achievement or other achievement of genetic engineering is the production of growth hormone. Growth hormone was produced using a bacterium called E. coli. E mean Escherichia. Escherichia coli was used in 1977 to produce growth hormone, GH. This hormone solves the problem of dwarfism, and it is also a major achievement of genetic engineering. The third achievement of genetic engineering is the production of a hormone called thymosin. Thymosin is a hormone which is effective for brain and lung cancer. The cancer of brain and lung can be resolved by a hormone called thymosin, and this hormone is being produced by using genetically modified organisms. It is also another achievement of genetic engineering. The fourth achievement of genetic engineering is beta endorphin. Beta endorphin is a natural painkiller. Produced by brain to relieve the pain. But if it is produced in less amount, you can get it from pharmacies because it has been and it is nowadays being produced by genetic engineering. The fifth achievement of genetic engineering is many types of vaccines, like a vaccine for foot and mouth disease in cattle, goats, deer, and the vaccines for hepatitis B are also an achievement of genetic engineering. Another achievement, the sixth achievement of genetic engineering, are interferon means the proteins which are produced when the cells get infected with viruses. The cells infected with viruses, produce special antiviral proteins which are called interferons. These help to kill the viruses and to relieve the viral infections. Nowadays, interferons are being produced by genetic engineering. The first interferon was prepared in 1980. The other achievement of genetic engineering is enzyme urokinase. Urokinase is an enzyme produced naturally in the human body to dissolve blood clots. When there is more than normal number of platelets in a patient, the person's or patient's blood starts to clot, and the function of urokinase is to dissolve the clots to prevent from the risk of heart attack or other cardiovascular disorders. Nowadays, this enzyme is being produced by genetic engineering, which is another major achievement of genetic engineering. The next achievement of genetic engineering is modification of egg cell in humans to treat inherited diseases like hemophilia. Many diseases come from mothers to the babies, and the changes of the egg cell has made it possible by genetic engineering to get rid of these inherited diseases like hemophilia, and it is another achievement of genetic engineering. The next another important achievement of genetic engineering is treating genetic disorders of blood, for example thalassemia, sickle cell anemia or leukemia. These blood disorders are because of a defective gene. By using the technique of genetic engineering, this defective gene is removed and an effective gene or proper functioning gene is inserted into the genome of the affected person, which is only possible because of genetic engineering. Genetic engineering have made some plants to able to fix nitrogen. As you know, most of the plants need bacteria in their roots, nodules, to fix the nitrogen, to get the nitrogen from the air. But now genetic engineering has made it possible for plants to fix nitrogen directly from the air. They don't need bacteria, which helps them to store their food, which they give to bacteria who give them nitrogen. Their food is saved and their chances of survival increase. Such plants which fix nitrogen are usually present in the areas which are deficient in nitrogen. Our next topic is single cell protein, SCP. Chapter 17, Biotechnology, Class 10, Biology. Single cell protein means the protein which is obtained from single cells. Proteins obtained from single celled organisms or microorganisms. Are called single cell proteins. To get single cell protein from microorganisms, microorganisms are provided with many types of substrates, and these substrates include industrial wastes and nitrogenous wastes. Industrial wastes and nitrogenous wastes are raw materials of the microorganisms. These substrates and microorganisms are put into a fermenter for an optimum and faster and optimum production of proteins from microorganisms. These microorganisms include algae, yeast, and bacteria. The smaller, the mini, the micro, the organism, the faster the production of protein from microorganism. Because single cell protein is obtained from microorganism, that is why single cell protein is also called mini food or novel food. Because microorganisms are a strange choice to produce protein, that is why novel food is used. Novel means strange, and mini because the organisms which are a source of the protein are very much small, that is why it is called mini food. A scientist known as Scrim Show at Massachusetts Institute of Technology discovered or made the first single cell protein, and now all the scientists agree on the importance of single cell protein. Because energy resources or food resources are declining or reducing with the increase in population due to overpopulation, the loss of resources poses a serious need of the production of single cell protein. To know about the importance of single cell protein, let's we study the key important points of single cell protein production. The importance of single cell protein lies in that just 50 kilogram yeast is able to produce 250 tons of protein in just 24 hours. Only and only 50 kg yeast is required to produce 250 ton of protein in 24 hours. This single cell protein is much more. It is about 20 to 50 times more amount as compared to the corn which is sown in an acre per year. The corn which is sown in an acre too much large area as compared to the area taken by yeast and amount as well. Also, in 1 acre in 1 year produces 2 to 50 times less protein as compared to this protein which is produced by genetic engineering, means single cell protein. So the importance of single cell protein can be understood by this comparison. Single cell protein uses very much less area of land. It produces too much proteins. The third advantage of single cell protein is that too much less time is required for production of single cell protein. Another benefit of single cell protein by microorganisms is that single cell protein is pure protein. The protein which is present in corn is mixed. Corn consists of carbohydrate, fat, and protein. it the grains of the corn contain very much less protein, but as compared to them, single cell protein is rich in its amount. Also, single cell protein with vitamin is obtained when we use yeast to get protein from. And much more other important lines or points exist in the production of single cell protein. It is the need of the time. Allah Hafiz.